Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to another episode of WiliestSoup's Space Engineer Survival. I apologize for the loud noise. That was ridiculous. I'm excited to be back. I'm doing a live, recording, but I'm not doing a voiceover this time because, well, the amount of work that it took to do the editing was a lot of fun, but I feel like you guys respond better to when I actually do real reactions and such like that. As I nearly kill myself. Wow, that kind of hurt. Anyways, so fun stuff has been happening. I have been working on another project for this, so that's all I'm going to tell you guys about. Not that I don't want you guys to know, even though I really do. But hopefully you will enjoy it. I am looking forward to doing it here really soon. So let's get some materials. Let's grab 100 of you and 100 of you. Oh yeah, and as you guys noticed, the UI, so the user interface is done. They released it last week, or Thursday actually. And I'm a little excited for that because, man, that's going to make things a lot easier for all of us, to be honest. So one thing that I am going to do is I'm going to be putting in a connector here, so let's get that together. Connector, there you are. And so that way, and you guys might be like, why would you do that? But the reason why I would do that is because sometimes you want to grab stuff inside the actual cockpit and you don't have it available, and because you don't have it available, it just makes it more difficult. Anyways, long story short, connector makes that possible. So one of the things that I plan on doing this episode is getting a lot of stuff done. Hopefully, as you guys can see, I have done a lot to the spacecraft itself. That took me about, 4 hours to build. I broke down a good portion of the pieces over there. I'm getting ready to put on the rest of the rockets, or the thrusters, sorry, hydrogen thrusters. Which I could do now, but I really don't want to have to worry about it. So one thing that I am planning on doing here, actually, is let's do this. Big mama jama. But anyways, like I said about the project that I'm working on, I really hope you guys enjoy it. And the reason why is because I'm excited. I am really, really, really excited for this project to be happening. Mainly because it's going to be kind of a thing that Last Stand Gamer does. I know a lot of you know who he is, but those of you that don't, he does seasons, and I think I'm going to start incorporating seasons as well. And the reason why that is because keeping up with this and working with this for every day, or not every day, but it's almost every day because I got to get a lot done, and there's a lot of editing, and you know, if you guys are YouTubers, you guys know the drill. You know what goes into it. It's not a secret. Does that look stupid? I feel like that kind of looks stupid. Well, if it does, too bad. Doesn't matter. I need a way to stop. So, one thing that I was going to try to do was put in a floor. But how should I go about doing that is the question. So yeah, like I was saying earlier, and like I've been saying for the past couple of times now, like the 100th time it feels like. You know what? Damn it. This is the reason why I usually do this off camera, because I make a lot of mistakes. A lot of things that I want to do different, and then I end up having to cut things out, and you guys are like, why'd you do that? And I don't know how to explain it to you sometimes. So, 9. Perfect. It's going to be like the 100th connector on that. There we go. So that will be on the floor. Right there. But like I was saying, if you guys happen to have any ideas of stuff that you want to see, I am more than willing to try to incorporate it if I can. If there's stuff that you're like, you know what, I think would be really fun to have or to see someone do, I'm willing to do it. Mainly because I think it would be fun to have as well. Let's put that. Let's see. Anything else I need over here? No, but I know exactly what I'm going to put here. And it's going to be gorgeous. Delicious. Okay, so let's turn you like that. Let's turn you. Damn it! Like that. It's been a while since I've done a live, or a live recording kind of thing. It's nice. I do enjoy doing it. Just so you guys know, it is actually quite entertaining for me. So let's go over here, and this will be the ceiling. I know this is kind of all over the place right now, but I'm trying to get things laid out so that way I can have an idea of what it is that I'm doing. Because there's certain things that I want to try to do. Yep. Ceiling goes there. So that's that. Let's get some oxygen in here. So why don't we have a little thing break off this. So let's come over here. Boom. Boom. And there, that'll work. We can put pipe like so. Hey. Thank you. Oh no, it would have to be a conveyor tube. Yeah. Huh. All right. That's good to know. Good thing we learned. Anyways, so a little bit of news, personal life. I don't know if you guys care, but if you do, a little bit of news for our personal life. We are looking to purchase a home, me and my wife. Are, and we're excited. We're shopping around, trying to see what we can find, what we can't find, you know, and such. And it's I know a lot of people talk about how stressful it is, and damn it, they are right. It is stressful. But it's nice. I'll be excited when it's done, but I'll also be excited when we got a house and are pretty well off, to be honest. Let's see, how am I going to pipe this through? Hey, thank you. So let's bring it. Let's see, I want it above the ceiling, right? Yes. So it's going to be above the ceiling. Need to turn it. There we go. So let's. Okay, this is the hard part because everything's sideways and. You know the drill. Oh, no. There we go. Okay, so. But yeah, so we've been having a lot of fun. We've been looking at homes, talking to bank people, doing the usual, trying to figure out what the heck it is we're going to do stuff. One more? Oh, no. Do this. There we go. And then 9. I'm sorry, guys. I'm having a hard time talking and. Or maybe not talking, but. Really? Let's see. It comes down 1. That'll be. Oh, it needs to be a box. Conveyor tube. And then a conveyor sorter. And then. Yay! There it is. So, if you guys are wondering what I'm building right now, I apologize, I'm not explaining very well, am I? But I am putting together an airlock. So, that's. What I'm trying to get done here. Let's put up a wall here. Boom. And that right there. Let's put in some flooring. So, there we go. Up. Like so. Perfect. Just like that. And then one more. And one more. There we go. Now we should be good as far as that is concerned. Let's come over here. Put this in. That's interesting. It's harder to go up. That's that makes sense, but still. Let's put you here, here. And I'm trying to make it airtight. So give me a second here. It's not working out the best, but doing what I can with what I got. Loving is what I got. There we go. You guys may have seen what I'm doing in a previous bit, but trust me, it's not what you think. Or maybe it is. If it is, congratulations, you figured it out. Right here. Boom. Like so. And then we will put an air intake here. Rotate it. Oh my gosh, I am on the struggle bus, you guys. Dang. Okay, let's do the same thing for this side. Actually, let's go check my hydrogen level, first of all. I think I'm pretty low. That is a correct assumption. I actually might lose hydrogen. Woo! I was close. Oh, it just refilled, okay. Alright, we're good. But, probably gonna put it in a downstairs, so probably should do that at some point. You guys get to listen to me ramble. Not really, it's probably really super annoying, and I'm apologizing for that. Sorry. Go over here, out, pun, do, there. There we go. Tight. Tight like a toyga. Yes. Perfect. Just like that. Sorry, guys. There's so much pauses. Ugh, this is going to be an awful episode. here we go. But yeah, so there is a lot more stress to buying a house than I originally had thought. I mean, obviously it makes sense, but dang. So that's one thing that is exciting for us is we're trying to get a home. So hopefully that makes sense to you guys is the reason why we're kind of struggling with that thought. That looks pretty good. I think I should weld that up and call that money. Money is cash. We should be good on that, right? Yeah, okay. Alright. Let's get welding it up. So let's come over here. Drop you off. And let's just grab some construction components just cuz. So, one thing that I'm super excited about this channel is it allows me to... Crap. It allows for me to be able to put together quite an interesting storyline. So I'm going to actually start incorporating story. If there's some of you out there that are like, no, don't do that, I'm sorry. I kind of want to. And there's a reason why. It's because it's kind of difficult for me to create things to talk about. Prime example is right now. I'm rambling. I'm just talking about random stuff. And because of that, sometimes it doesn't create the best content, at least for you. And I want you guys to be entertained. I mean, it's important to me that you're entertained. One, because you pay me money for your entertainment. And two, I mean, you don't, but the advertisers do. So that's important. And that money is used for better equipment for me. And I hope that that money comes back to you. So that way you guys can have good quality entertainment. And second of all, I like being able to have constructive storylines, not just, you know, bullcrap that I talk about all the time. Yeah, that's what I needed. I'm out? Oh, I was out of constructive bonus, I didn't realize. Oh, okay. Oh, what am I doing? I can come over here and grab it.
Ugh. Ugh. Dang it.
Boop, 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 boop. Oh, oh, ow. Air vent. That. That. Air vent. That. And then this still wasn't finished correctly. Right? There we go. Woo! You got construction components, you got construction components. You get a car, you get a car. You get a car. Yeah, probably better if I came from the backside. Ha, backside. I'm honestly trying to think of stuff to talk about, guys. I'm sorry. Oh, hey. So I mentioned this in a other episode, but for those of you that haven't watched that episode, which might be more than a few, it's not a big... I wasn't meaning that bad. I'm sorry. That came across bad. So I don't know if you guys heard about my wife and my honeymoon, and before you get any thoughts of like, oh, it's going to be gross and dirty, it's not. Because usually the hanky-panky takes place on a honeymoon. Not ours, and it's not because of my wife. It was because of me. And before any of you start writing damn erectile jokes, you bastards, it was not bad either. I ended up getting sick. So the story is, I'm working full-time. I was actually working two jobs. So I was working at, as delivering pizzas, and I was also an HVAC installer. Now, I don't know if you guys know what an HVAC installer is. It's where I install furnaces and air conditioners into people's homes, so I give them heat and air conditioning. And I was the guy that installed it for people. Not that it's that big of a job. It's not. It paid a little bit more than minimum wage, and that's about it. But so anyways, long story short, I was gonna grab something. Small steel plates. Let's just grab interior plates. So, my wife and I get married. I had been working full-time, so I had been working around 80 hours a week. About 60 hours a week. And I'm in constant contact with people that are sick, because I don't know about you guys, but when I'm sick, I order pizza. You guys may not, but I do. And, one of the things that would happen is I would get sick from other people all the time. It happened constantly. And so anyways, I start feeling a little under the weather, but I'm like, well, it's just a cold. And so I kind of just ignored it. We went on our honeymoon. We got married on a Saturday, left on our honeymoon on a Tuesday. And we stayed until Monday of the next week. Anyways, so long story short, while on the plane, I started getting the chills. Now, have you guys ever had the chills before? I mean, I'm fairly positive some of you have, but my goodness, the chills are awful. Where, you know, you're just cold. There's nothing you can do. I'm on that plane. My wife is fine. Everybody else is fine, but I'm freezing to death. And, I mean, obviously not to death, or else I would be dead. So I'm super cold. I have my wife's jacket. I have my jacket on, and I'm still cold. And that's when it dawned on me that I didn't just have a cold. I had something else, because I never get the chills when I have a cold. Some people do, some people don't. I don't. And so, long story short, I'm sitting there and I'm like, well, this is shit. So we get to our place of stay for the next week. And as I'm... So as I'm getting ready to die, it feels like, we get to bed, and I'm so hot I can barely stand it. To the point where, like, I had a fever of like 103. Should have gone to the hospital or at least a doctor or something. Didn't. Because we were poor. You know, we had just gotten married. We had no money. And so I'm being stubborn. My wife was like, you need to go to the doctor. I didn't listen. Of course I didn't listen. Why would I? I'm a typical man. And so I end up getting worse. I'm to the point where I'm bedridden. We didn't even go out and do anything. We were at Lake Tahoe, which I don't know if those of you that don't know where Lake Tahoe is. Lake Tahoe is on the border of Nevada and California states in the United States. And nice place. Beautiful place. I highly recommend it. If you guys ever have the opportunity to visit it, take the chance, because it was gorgeous. Even though we didn't get to do shit, it was still a beautiful place to go. So again, long story short, I don't need anything else right here. Nope. Okay. So it's all soup plates. So, long story short, again, I'm sorry, I keep rambling. I finally go to the doctor, and it's like 3 days until we go home. And I'm fairly positive most of you can figure out what it is. By the time I had gone to the doctor, I had developed bronchitis. Now, bronchitis, I'm very susceptible to bronchitis because of when I was 20. I had just turned 20, and I got pneumonia. And I mean, I got pneumonia bad because I was an idiot. I was working hard for my dad, and because I was working hard for my dad, long story short, I didn't want to be the one that was causing everybody else issues because I was cold, you know what I mean? Some of you might be like, well, you're a dumbass. Well, you know what, you're right, I was being a dumbass. So anyways, I got pneumonia. I got pneumonia so bad that when I went to the doctor and talked to the doctor about having pneumonia, he basically said if I hadn't come in the next day, I probably would have been dead. So, needless to say, there's some damage to my lungs. And so that's why sometimes when you guys like hear me breathe, it's so loud. I'm actually not that close to the microphone. But when I breathe, it is very, very loud. And it's actually really kind of annoying to me personally. Because like, there'll be times I'll be editing the video and I gotta rewatch the footage. And I go to rewatch the footage and I'm like hearing myself going, you know, and I'm just like, oh my gosh. And so I try to cut it out when I can, but damn. So I'm sorry, you guys just had to listen to that. That's awful. You guys are probably like, well, I'm subscribing. Yeah, I wouldn't blame you. But anyways, damn it, I don't know why you guys stick around. Anyways, for those of you that do, you guys are super cool. Appreciate it.
Okay, I can't fit through there, apparently. All right.
So yeah, we go to the doctor. The doctor basically says, yeah, you have really bad bronchitis because you didn't come to the doctor in time. And I was like, well, okay, that makes sense because typical something I do. So I had really bad bronchitis. He gives me antibiotics. The next day, I feel better. Now, I had been feeling like shit all week. And I mean to the point where I was not even cognizant. I remember... maybe 2 days of the entire honeymoon. It was awful. And I mean, to the point where we decided to redo our honeymoon. So we decided we're going to redo our honeymoon because that honeymoon was shit, which it was. And we decided to go on a cruise. And we went on an Alaskan cruise because we live in Washington State. And we figured, you know what, if we could just drive up to Seattle, which is what we did, and not have to get a hotel, get a flight, you know, and just pay for the cruise itself, we can put the money that we would have put on a hotel and flight and put it into the cruise, which is what we did. And it was awesome. It was one of the best decisions we ever made. Made for an awesome time. Honestly, anybody who's listening to this and is like, hey, I would like to go cruising, don't put it off. Seriously, put as much money as you can away, or save it, or just book it now and just make payments. That's exactly what we did. Is we kind of wanted to go as soon as possible, kind of thing. Or not as soon as possible. We wanted to go within a year. So got home from our whole entire shitty from our shitty honeymoon, and we're like, that was shit. And so we're like, we're booking a cruise, and we did for the next year. And we got a cruise for the next year for a reasonable price, and we were able to make payments on it. And we made payments, and we went on the cruise. And just kind of as a heads up, like, we don't make that much money. We're less than the national average of how much money we make. We're considered poor. That's what I'm trying to say. And we were able to go on a cruise. So for those of you that are like, yeah, I want to go on a cruise and such like that, but it's just so expensive. The only reason why a cruise would be expensive is if you had to fly or travel to it. And if that's the case, that's really a bummer. However, there is no reason why you shouldn't go. What you should do then is just save a little bit extra money and then book a flight to go. I know I sound like a cruise salesman, or a cruise line salesman. I don't know. I don't know what you call that. Whatever, it doesn't matter. Anyways, but yeah, so honestly, seriously, you guys, you need to go. It's awesome. It's one of the most amazing experiences I've ever had in my entire life. And if I could do it again, I would. And just so happens, I am. I'm going on a cruise. So for those of you that have not asked, buttholes, nobody cares, jerks. Anyways, the vacation that I'm going on in a couple of weeks is on a cruise. We're going on another cruise. So this will be the second year in a row we've gone on a cruise. And I gotta tell you, my wife and I, we are excited. Mainly because we were able to work up the money to be able to go on a second cruise, because it's kind of something we want to do. Seriously, again, go on a cruise, damn it. Like, I can't tell you how awesome it is to just, like, travel. So you're on the boat, you get a balcony, which if you don't get a balcony, you're pretty much a dum-dum. But get on a balcony and go basically just watch the water go by. Like, that was fun in and of itself. But then you're in a boat. That's another one. I would play a song, but I'm afraid I'll get copyright infringement again. So you're on a boat. You're basically traveling from point A to point B. You don't have to drive. You don't have to get on a train or worry about deadlines or worry about any of that other crap. You just get on a boat and go, and you sit by. You get to eat a shit ton of food. Now, if there's a bunch of health critics out there, they have healthy food too. That's the way it works. But listen to me ramble on, damn. Some of you guys are probably going to just leave the episode, or probably have already left the episode. Thanks for those of you who stuck around. Appreciate it. But some of you probably left the episode because you're just like, well, he's talking about cruise ships. This is not Space Engineers. Peace out. But anyways, so one of the things that's really awesome about cruise ships is you can eat as much as you want. You don't have to drive. You go places. You see the world. You see things that you never would see otherwise because it's by boat. Remember that part? Yeah, I'm on a boat. And it's just awesome. I don't know. You pay a lump sum. Food's covered. Transportation's covered. And then, you know, room's covered, obviously. And you're good to go. So, yeah. I was sold. So was my wife. She thought it was pretty great. Okay. Let's see here. Well, it looks like I'm probably going to have to let you guys go. I'm going to continue working on this so that way I can get this ship built by hopefully this Thursday. And then I'll have a special little segment for you guys on Thursday. No promises, but I am going to try my hardest to get it done. Anyways, guys, I really appreciate you guys coming out today and checking out this episode. It was really fun to make, surprisingly. I started out really slow. I'm sorry about the beginning because it was just, you know, I couldn't think of anything to talk about. And then I thought about my honeymoon, and then I thought about cruise ships. So you guys got a real humdinger on that one, huh? And so I'm really excited to be doing this series, guys. I really appreciate you guys supporting me. So if you guys could leave a like down below, it really helps me out, helps me know what you guys enjoy, what you don't enjoy. Also, if you guys could have any comments and such like that, leave a comment. I love talking to you guys. I love hearing from you guys. I do try to respond as often as I can. There's times that I can't get to it right away, you know, because sometimes you guys respond after I post a video, and sometimes I post a video and just go to bed. And so that's the reason why that happens, and I'm sorry if that's bothersome. But anyways, guys, if you guys have anyone that you think would enjoy this video or would have a good time with it, please leave share it with them and see if they can enjoy it a little bit more or something like that. And last but not least, if you guys haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I release videos like this every day, and I will do my best to do better about my schedule. I have been doing a lot of stuff. I'm a manager for the property that I live at. Long story, I had to take care of a bunch of stuff. A toilet decided to self-destruct, so that was unpleasant, to say the least. But anyways, guys, I really appreciate you guys coming out. Thank you once again, and I will see you guys on Thursday, and I hope you guys have a wonderful Monday. Until then, have a wonderful couple days, guys. Bye.